everybody. Morgan, thanks for joining us again on the stream. So, we wanted to show off a little bit of the new content coming to the game tomorrow, and it's just about Lunar New Year time, so we're going to have some objects and some clothing accessories that celebrates all of that. So, well, let's swap over to the game, Steve.
There you go.
And today, we've got a whole family of 8 Sims, and they are all wearing some new content for us. And before we delve into seeing all the new goodies, Morgan has built this family for us. She did not build the lot. We'll take a look at that one in a second. But this family will be up on the gallery tomorrow, probably. Tomorrow?
Yeah, probably tomorrow.
Okay. give us a little bit of their history, Morgan, because I know you were very meticulous in creating them.
Well, people care about the history, and they're always like, what's their names? Where are they from?
Yeah. So the people on the far left, the two older, they're like the dad of this family's parents. They're from Shang Simla. And they're more traditional older people. If you look at their traits, you can learn a little bit more about their personalities, and their sort of aspirations and everything, and what they want out of life. The grandpa is a little bit more of a perfectionist, and he's a bookworm, and he's kind of neat, and he's kind of like a, what's the word? Is it fastidious?
Sure, that works.
Whoa. Yeah, fancy words, Morgan.
Throwing out these words.
Is that a new trait coming to The Sims 4?
No, that just kind of describes his general feel. That's who this guy is. And his name is Elon? Zhao. They're all Zhaos. They're the Zhao family.
Yep.
Yeah. And then his wife, her name is Mei Ling. And she is really self-assured and outgoing, and she's family-oriented. I like to think she's a little bit of a busybody, and she really cares about her family, though. but that's who she is. And then their son...
And just a note, while we're going through them, we do have some new clothing on them. So, let's see. Yilong there, he's got a new jacket on, and we'll see a variant of that on the dad in a moment. And then this is Mei Ling. Mei Ling, yep. And she's got a nice traditional dress on. Really cool.
So, Matt has really pretty variants.
Yeah.
They all do, but... The dad there, not the next lady, but the next one, he's their son. And he is family-oriented. So I thought maybe he was a little bit like his mom, he was a little bit like his dad, so he got the family-orientedness from his mom, and then he got the neat and fastidiousness from his dad. But he's also a foodie. He really likes food. That's kind of like his own personality thrown in there.
So I think he's, well, this one's kind of interesting, and I just want to ask Cheyenne. Cheyenne's actually our art director on all of the content that's coming in tomorrow's patch. But I think it's kind of cool because we have these Chinese characters, but they're not real Chinese characters.
Right.
They're like Simlish. So how do you make a fake Simlish Chinese character that's different from our normal Simlish?
We did want to make it read as an Asian language, but nothing too specific, and we also had people who read different Asian languages take a look and make sure we weren't accidentally saying anything we didn't want to, but we did want to represent the spirit.
Yeah. All right, and I think we
That's
skipped
really
over.
That's really cool. I hadn't thought about that. Being like,
it's a challenge
actual.
For
That's
sure.
really cool.
Yeah.
So she is not from Shang Simla, but they met. She grew up in, you guys can choose the town. What are the towns we've released? I would say maybe Brindleton Bay, but you guys can choose. And her name's Alice, and her family has been in Brindleton Bay for one generation. But we didn't have, like, her family, I don't know, you could make them if you wanted, I suppose. But it's not really about her, it's about the Zhaos. So anyways,
she married into the family.
She married into the family, and she is the guy on the left, right, wife. And she is like a super fashionista geek who's also a genius, and she's family oriented. But like, if you look at all of her clothes, I think she's kind of like hip and cool.
And she's got that awesome new dress.
Yeah.
And actually, we'll zoom in closely here because she has some new accessories as well. She's got the jade necklace on and then some really cute fan earrings.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the sparkles on the top of her dress.
Yeah, so that one has variants that look a little bit more appropriate for Chinese New Year, but you can also just go out to a nice dinner or go partying with this too.
Yeah. Then we've got our kids.
So this is Michael, and can we look at his traits? He's a goofball. Yeah, he's a goofy kid. Actually, have it that he's the second oldest. So, I don't know. They might be the same age in-game, but he's, like, the second oldest one in my mind, even though it might have them as the same age because we're starting them fresh.
Yep.
Yeah.
And so, he's rocking an awesome new jacket.
He is. Some of his outfits used, I think more than one outfit uses that jacket. It's really good to use in lots of ways.
Yep. And then Tiffany.
Tiffany's a little nerd like her mom. She's a genius too. But her mom dresses are super cute. But I think she's a little bit more inclined to be tomboyish, but her mom always dresses are super cute.
And I think this dress has a number of variants, yep. Right, Cheyenne? So we've got some of the patterned ones, we've got some plain ones, and there's a few different patterns as well, I believe, mm-hmm. Right?
For all yeah. The kids' outfits, we did some more holiday-appropriate colors, but then we have some fun patterns for just any time.
I love the both the toddlers. I caught them checking out her dress, too. So who do we have here, Morgan?
These are the twins. It's Melody and Melanie. And I think Melody has like one of the more like classically toddler outfits that would work for Guy mm-hmm. Sims too for like a toddler boy, but
yep, that top's unisex.
Yeah, but I wanted them to be twins, so I made it work for a girl. and then the hair can be unisex too. It's a really cute new toddler hair.
Yep, brand new hair, very adorable. And these ones actually have really cute patterns. There's some with like koi fish mm-hmm. And yeah, just fun.
And those two are opposite personality-wise. I think one of them's clingy and yep. The other one's really independent. Mm-hmm. Yep.
So that's the family, and that's a look at some of the new clothing that's coming tomorrow. So let me zoom out here and show off the lot now. I did not build this lot myself. I went on our gallery and found a very talented creator. I think Steve is going to share a link in the chat.
So I didn't share a link, but I did share who it was by.
Okay, well... Some information is getting shared in the chat, and I will make sure to actually tweet it later. So if you want to go find this lot and play around with it, you are more than welcome to do so. I think it's gorgeous. Not only did they do a really nice garden in the backyard, which will be just perfect for celebrating Lunar New Year with, but the interior is super detailed as well. I think it really gets the theme nailed. So. Let's take a look at some of the new objects that are coming. Actually, right behind the parents here, we had a brand new pig statue. It is the year of the earth pig in China this year. So that's something fun. And then we've got some new citrus trees because that's a very big part of Lunar New Year. You want to have a lot of citrus in your home. It's good luck. And then as we move inside, we've got kind of a new dining room set up. So you're going to get a 6-seater round dining table, new dining chair to come with that. Again, we've got our pig statue, some other fun variants with the all gold one. Nice big basket of oranges. We've got red envelopes. And if people don't know about Lunar New Year, one of the traditions is that you typically have adults give children money and they're inside these red envelopes. So that's a fun little gift. We've got another little decorative object there, very cute. And one of the nice things about this update is there's some new recipes coming. So I'm actually going to get the adults coming in here and we'll cook some new food. And reunion dinners are actually a really big part of Lunar New Year. You get the whole family together and make something delicious that they can all enjoy. So I think we'll go down and... Let's have a mud carp. Tastes better than it sounds. the mud carp's kind of fun. I was just looking up some stuff about Lunar New Year online, and fish in particular, I believe, kind of represents the idea of abundance in the new year. And so one little trick I learned is you want to leave one serving of fish behind at your Lunar New Year dinner, because that way you're blessed with abundance for the entire year. Let's move her out of the way because we're going to need that oven in a second. And while they're cooking, I want to bring the toddlers in.
These are new lanterns, by the way.
Yes, they are. Zoom in on, whoop, I got to avoid the fade. We got these cool new Chinese lanterns. And actually, out in the hallway there, I put, those paper lanterns are from Base Game, mm-hmm. But we added a new red color variant because red's very important for Lunar
Absolutely.
New Year. So they're prepping food in there, but we've got these cute new panda toys as well. One of the toddlers have a good time with those. Come on over there, little ones. I haven't got a red trash can for this one. That's mine. That didn't come with the house. I picked that one out. So that is an adorable little new toy for toddlers and kids. And it looks like our mud carp is done. So let's have Alice make us our other new recipe. It's going to be some vegetable dumplings. And were you involved in picking out the recipe, Cheyenne?
A little bit. Yeah, we also had some guidance as to what is appropriate for the holiday.
Mm-hmm.
We just wanted to pick things that were appropriate and looked fun, and that we didn't have these things in the game before, so it's nice adding new stuff.
Yeah, for sure. This one's cool because it's a veggie dish, so for any Sims with the vegetarian trait.
Like me.
Perfect. The other fun thing I found out, just, you know, again, reading about Lunar New Year online, the dumplings, my understanding at least, is that they're somewhat symbolic for wealth because the shape and color of them look somewhat like gold ingots.
That's so. Kind of like the other sculpture too. The it's called like a golden boat or something like that.
Yeah, I didn't want to butcher the name of it. Sorry, I'm going to move the camera back to it. I think it was called like a Psyche or...
It's got multiple names.
Let's look at the name of it.
Do
you remember much about these?
It's based off of the old currency that they used to have, so it symbolizes wealth.
Okay, perfect.
It's pretty.
That was quite the story built by there.
Yeah, so I did not do the text for these ones.
That
was Joe. I'm not sure Joe has been on a stream before. So.
Oh, Joe.
All right, let's get our dumplings. Delicious. So we'll go ahead and let's do the dumplings as an appetizer. Get the family over here for a meal. And we'll get our mud cart for the next course. And we'll sit down to a nice dinner.
Yeah,
those are amazing.
They're cute, right? So how about some of the symbols on the objects, Cheyenne? Is that kind of the same story?
Yeah.
We just had to kind of figure out stuff that looked to the part but didn't mean anything in particular?
And it was a little bit easier to simplify and make it read from a distance. But it's nice because it ties all the furniture together. And then we also have different colors that don't include it and are a little bit more simple if you don't want this kind of theme.
Looks like Grandma and Grandpa didn't have time for appetizers. They're going straight for the main course.
That makes me hungry.
Yeah.
Like 11:50.
So yeah, that's a look at some of the new stuff that's coming tomorrow. We got a nice collection of objects, two new recipes for you, some brand new clothing and accessories, and that'll be really fun to play with, and it's just in time. Lunar New Year is tomorrow, so... Celebrate. Yeah, look out for that update.